Hey guys, Mr. BXRP here, and welcome back. Today is June 29th of 2020. I am back from vacation. If you saw my vacation video, I was out on the beach on Marco Island for a few days and probably got a little too much sun, but it was a good time. It was a little bit weird. The whole CV situation made the whole thing a little bit weird. People in masks and hotel was incredibly understaffed, so getting service out there was not easy. But anyway, I am back, and let's talk about things. So market's looking flat. I mean, we're at $264 billion. Bitcoin's at 91.81. Ethereum's at 226. Tether is holding at a dollar. And XRP is at 17.7 cents. So that's where we're at on the market. Nothing too exciting. Let's go through some of this stuff. From Michael at VAL5Link, he had posted this on Twitter. Binance has completed its biggest platform upgrade in 2 years. It's getting the speed ready for the next crypto bull run. So Binance is souping things up, which is fantastic. And from what I understand, I don't think they're having much trouble for those people who have Binance. I don't see them complaining very much. I do hear a lot of people complaining about Coinbase, and I sure hope that Coinbase is ramping things up over there. We'll have to wait and see how they're doing over there, but hopefully they'll do the same thing, because they certainly need some help over there, because their platform is constantly going down and they need some help. Moving on. So Leonidas had posted this, and he's at xrparcade.com, and he did this really cool Ripple timeline. So essentially you can go back in time and all of the high points of Ripple, what they've done. So they were founded in 2004, first commit in 2011, OpenCoin in 2012, let's see here, angel funding round in 2013, Jed McCaleb leaves in 2013, let's see here, changed the name to Ripple Labs in 2013. This is just really, really cool stuff. So you need to go to his website, check this out. And moving on toward today, let's see what a couple of the highlights were close to today, because there's something I want to point out. Let's look. Oh, it looks like right around, let's see here. Okay, December 20th, 2019, Series C funding. Ripple announces $200 million in Series C funding led by Tetragon with participation from SBI Holdings and Route 66 Ventures. We still don't know what that $200 million was for. I mean, it is June 29th. And we haven't seen them make an acquisition, but we did hear Brad Garlinghouse mention acquisitions recently in a video. So my guess is it's got to do with acquisitions and or their IPO. And from what I heard from Cryptopolis, who is really sharp on the markets, that most companies, if they're going to IPO, typically do it around July. So if Ripple's going to go this year, it's probably going to happen by the end of July. Otherwise, it most likely won't be this year, but we will have to wait and see like everything else. Moving on. So Michelle O'Connor, who works for, and she's at MQ20CO, she works for Uphold. And she had posted this the other day. It's an exciting day for Uphold team. Today, we launched the easiest way to buy U.S. equities. You can now invest as little as a dollar in popular stocks like Apple, Tesla, and more. Don't just protect your wealth, create it. This is a game changer for Uphold, guys. You know, we know that Robinhood's been doing this now. I don't know if they have the same exact equities and you can get in and out of the same things, but I think there's a lot more people in the crypto space on Uphold. So you can now, I believe, not yet in the United States, though. It's not here in the States yet, but for the people who it is available to, I believe you can go from Bitcoin to Apple and from Apple to whatever you want, really, to Tesla. Really neat stuff. This is the direction the world's going in. We heard this, you know, I heard this a year and a half ago that you'll be at your local grocery store and you will be able to take your phone out and buy your groceries, converting your Apple stock to whatever the fiat is in that store at that time, because I don't know what's going to happen by the time that's available, but I think it's coming. It's going to be amazing. The liquidity between investments and fiat and cryptocurrencies. It's just we're moving in a direction that's going to blow most people's minds. We're expecting it because we're in the space, right? So we've been expecting it for some time now. But for most people who don't follow the things that we follow, it's going to blow their minds. They're not going to be able to believe it. This from XRP Crypto Wolf. SBI VC Trade just launched their mobile app, VC Trade SP, today. So now you can easily buy and sell and trade crypto assets like XRP, Ethereum, and Bitcoin. So SBI launched their mobile app, which is really cool. It's going to make it easy for their customers to buy and sell digital assets. So that's fantastic. And it's just good to see some activity over there from SBI. And hopefully that'll help drive the market a little bit over there. XRP Crypto Wolf also posted this yesterday, last night, Mr. B, XRP's moonshot interview. So, and let me read it for you. XRP community, check out my fourth Coil article, which is an interview with XRP YouTuber Mr. B XRP to learn extremely interesting information about Mr. B XRP and his investments. Guys, I don't know how extremely interesting it is, but Crypto Wolf did ask me to do a written interview, and I did do it with him. So if you're looking for it, you can go to Twitter, and I retweeted it, or you can go to @XRPCryptoWolf, and you can read the interview that I did with him. So it was fun. It was interesting. I've never done it before. But I was glad I did. I've never done a on video interview, so this is the closest thing I've done to an interview. So I want to make you aware of it. Another reminder, if you still have assets in Toast Wallet, you need to get them out. Okay? So if you haven't heard by now, Toast Wallet is shutting down. So get your assets out of Toast Wallet. I am sure that somebody can tell how much assets, you know, whatever assets they are in Toast Wallet. And there's probably a ton still. People don't know about it. Get your stuff out of Toast Wallet, guys. They're shutting it down over there. So last, I don't know. I mean, I'm gonna say last warning from me because I don't know if I'm ever gonna talk about it again. But get it done. This from MacAttack XRP. Many people don't know this yet. Everyone in the world is going to use RippleNet equipped with on-demand liquidity (ODL) service. Ripple's own digital asset XRP acts as a connector between two currencies, sending and receiving payments at the fastest rate. Here's the best part. All the Bitcoin maximalists out there that don't like XRP and trash it every day, someday they're going to be using XRP and not even know it. And that's the beauty of XRP is it's going to be automatic. People aren't even going to know they're using it, and they're going to be using it, which is really, really cool. Unstoppable domains. I see a lot of people talking about unstoppable domains on Twitter. A little bit in YouTube videos. I just nailed down MrBXRP.crypto today. I'm going to play this short video for you so you can see what unstoppable domains is. It's about a minute and a half, and then I'll explain a little bit more about it.
What is a blockchain domain? A blockchain domain is like a .com or .org, except that the records are stored on a blockchain. Blockchain domains do two things that regular domains can't: simplify crypto payments and build uncensorable websites. Blockchain domains replace cryptocurrency addresses with a human-readable name. Add your crypto addresses, your Bitcoin, Ethereum, Litecoin, and any other cryptocurrency addresses all to one domain. Now someone just needs to type your domain into a wallet and send. No need to remember long addresses. The same domain can be used for websites. Traditional domains, also called DNS, are part of a centralized system controlled by ICANN, an international organization that maintains the records of who owns what domain. Blockchain domains are not part of the traditional domain system. They are what's called alternate routes. Domains are stored by you in your wallet, just like a cryptocurrency. No one can move them without the private key. Blockchain domains can also be used to build an uncensorable website. This works by pointing content from a decentralized storage network to your domain. Blockchain domains require browser plugins to resolve inside most standard browsers because they are new and not yet supported by the traditional system. Traditional website content is stored on centralized servers that are controlled by large companies. These companies can easily take down your site if they object to it or at the request of a government. Decentralized networks like IPFS store content that only you can put up and take down. Blockchain domains plus decentralized storage equals an internet that no company or government can censor. This technology has the power to spread free speech across the world. Find your blockchain domain today at www.unstoppabledomains.com.
So pretty neat stuff. What's really cool about this is once you set up your Unstoppable domain account, once you have your name, from what I understand, you'll be able to link your different cryptocurrency addresses to the name. And then if somebody's going to pay you, they just have to plug in your name. So technically, if I were to connect one of my XRP accounts to MrBXRP.crypto, you could just send me XRP to that address, which I highly recommend anybody who's got any used XRP that you don't want anymore. You could probably do that once I get it set up. I haven't set it up yet. But in all seriousness, pretty neat stuff. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a link in the description of this video. Anybody that's interested in one, I'll leave a link for you there. And you could check it out if you want to. Moving on, I thought this was great. This is funny footage of Apollo Nash astronauts falling on the moon, and NASA put this out. There's over 2 million views on this, and hopefully when we go to the moon, we're not acting like this. But I'm going to play this while I read my disclaimer and let you guys watch this. And I am not a financial advisor, I'm not an accountant, and I'm not an airline pilot, and I'm also not a crypto expert. These are my opinions only. Don't make any financial decisions based on anything I say. This video is intended for entertainment purposes only. Please like and subscribe and hit the notifications button and share with anybody who you think might do the same. And everyone have a fantastic day.